Oh, that could be fun, maybe. I don't know though. It is different. Hello, my lovely nestlings. If you are new, my name is Nikki. I'm 45, from the Netherlands, hence the accent. I love to play with color. And and I love indie brands and drugstore. That's basically the gist of what I'm doing, I think at least. A lot of you said, well, not a lot of you, but some of you told me over and over again that I needed to try out Glam Shop Poland. And I saw Angelica's video with the singles that she ordered as well. I will link the video down below if I can find it. Otherwise, I will just link her channel. But I am very, very bad at picking out single shades. If you are not new to my channel, you know I prefer palettes over singles. And the reason for that is because while I'm a very creative person, that kind of hinders me a little bit in making my own color stories. There are then so many gorgeous things, so many options that I don't know what to pick. Also, because I have a channel, it's easier for me to grab a palette than to list a bunch of singles. And I hope that makes sense. I do have some singles. The singles that I love, or that I have, I love. But I prefer either a complete bundle that you can get in a bundle or a palette. So what did I order? I actually ordered two palettes from Glam Shop Poland. I will show you the one we're not going to play with today as well, which is called, I don't know, Zielone? I don't know how to speak Polish, so probably butchering it very well. But it's the greeny one. Why am I not doing the greeny one today? Because for the greeny one, I just want to create three looks. I don't want to play with it first right now. I just want to create three looks. But oh, she's so pretty. Yeah, it's a very, very, very pretty color story. And I just wanted to create three looks with it instead of also doing, I don't know, another video where I'm also trying out other things. I just want to focus on the green palette. Does that make sense? I hope so. So a video with that one will come. Today, however, I am playing with the, I don't know, Morelova, I think it is. Which is, I think, peach. I don't know if it is a kind of peach or that it is just the Polish word for peach. I don't know, but there are 9 shades in here. You get a combination of mattes and shimmers. The mattes are pretty, I don't know if pigmented is the correct word, but I pick up a lot when I dig my finger in, and I am not very rough when I swatch, but yeah, my finger just picked up a lot of eyeshadow. The shimmers though, oh my lordy lord, they are just, and I don't even think that the camera does them justice, because when I look at them, there's also a sparkle, an extra sparkle in there, and there's already a shade that I am very, very much in love with, which is the shade, I don't know, is it Bacalia? This one, which is I don't even think that you can see it, but basically it is a multi-chrome. It reminds me of the highlighter that I have from Becca that I love so much. It's, yeah, again, I don't even think you can, maybe I can swatch or show you a little bit better on my finger. So basically it is a peach with a pink and a green in it. And it is like that highlighter from Becca. I don't know if they sell this shade individually. But on the other hand, if I look at the color story, yeah, this palette is basically worth getting it for this shade alone. If that is the shade that you are looking for, because I know that I love that highlighter so, so much. And it is gorgeous on olive skin. But if, yeah, Becca is going out of business, this is a very, very nice alternative for that shade. So yeah, I'm very, very excited about this. What I also got was the foundation. And this is the shade Olequa 1, or 1. 1 is Dutch for 1. It was the only olive one that they had when I ordered. It's probably too light for me, but I'm going to try it anyway. I'm very, very interested to try this one. The claims, yeah, there are, the claims are in Polish, so I don't know. I also got a few lip liners. I got 3 lip liners. I think that the first shade that I show you is Tsari Nude. That's how I would pronounce it, which is a very cool toned, almost, when I look at it, it almost has a little bit of a purple in it. Very cool toned. And then the next shade I'll show you is Silisti Rus, I think. So, I don't know. I want to say a pinkier nude, but you know. And then the last one is Jasny Karmelek. I think I'm butchering the names because I'm basically kind of pronouncing them the Dutch way, which is not the correct way, I think. But yeah, so they feel really creamy. I think I tried out one. They feel nice and creamy, so I'm very excited to try the other ones. Then I also got two lippies. The first one that you will see is the shade Biscoptoa. I don't know. It's very nice and sparkly, and it is an orangey, nudie shade. They are a very comfortable formula. I think I tried one of these as well. And then the other shade is a Mirabelka. I don't know which one I will use today. I also have a blush from Catrice, a new blush that I thought would complement the palette very, very well. This is in the shade Dolce Vita. I have already tried this one. It's very, very nice. I also have, maybe I can use this one too. I don't know. Can you open, please? I don't know if I can use this as a blush though. We shall see. I also have a new blush from Essence in the shade Bespoke, which is I have it here. I don't know if I want to use it as a blush or a blush topper or a bronzer. I don't know. I haven't decided yet. It's kind of a wonky color. I also have a highlighter from them, from Essence. Ooh, pretty. In the shade Mesmerizing, which is here, which is maybe a little bit too icy almost for this look, but we will see. Maybe I will just grab the shade Bacalia from the palette, or maybe even my Becca highlighter. I haven't decided yet. I want to know how the shades hold up, so I'm going to use glitter primer on one eye and no glitter primer on the other. I think that's it. I think I'm going to start with brows though. I don't think that the shades will be too fallouty the way that I'm feeling them, at least. So let's for funsies do face first again. I don't know if it is a matte foundation, or I have no idea though. Let me grab a little bit of foundation on the sheet, because I don't know if I want to use a primer or not. It does dry down on its own. Yeah, I think I want a hydrating primer underneath, just because I can. And I'm using the Catrice hydrating primer. I really like this primer. I really, really like this primer. I like a hydrating primer anyway. I'm using my Bumblebee brow jam today. Oh yes, and it's pretty windy, so if you hear anything, it's either the cat breathing very heavily or the wind. Fun fact, this one, he can snore so loud that when I'm downstairs and I'm working on the computer and he is in one of the kitty baskets on the other end of the room, I can hear him snoring. He can make so much noise. It's a pretty liquidy foundation, which I don't mind at all. It is also pretty light, which I usually do mind, but we will see. Okay, so a little goes a long way. Yeah. So again, this is shade one. This is probably my, I don't know, depth of winter color. I'm light medium, yeah, kinda. I think I'm light, and then light olive, but if you are fair olive, this shade might just work very, very well for you. Again, it is shade one. I do need to darken it up a bit, bronzing wise. Oh yeah, but that wasn't what I'm saying. I tan so quickly in my face at least, and I actually never really noticed until I really started paying attention to it. Yeah, it's very pale. The downside is I cannot really bring it down because of the tattoo, that it is still fresh and new, you know, so I don't want a lot of product on there. Now I can use a different foundation to mix in, you know, to darken it up a little bit, or darkening drops. I do prefer though to mix a darker foundation of the same foundation type in usually. It is already setting, so let's for funsies build it up a tad on certain places, because I kind of want to, let's build it up here, because it doesn't matter if it is a little bit lighter here, you know, it saves me from using concealer there. It does feel very, very light on the skin. So I just looked it up on the website and they have a shade olive that's even lighter than this. So if you are fair olive, check out the foundation. Because they again have one that is lighter than this, which is classified as a light, slightly olive shade. Yeah, well, if this is shade one, it is two shades too light for me, maybe even three. So again, depth of winter, it feels very comfortable. It's kind of setting, but it's not... Sometimes you can feel a foundation setting, especially with more affordable foundations. My drugstore foundations, a lot of them I can feel when they are setting. This one is drugstore price because it retails for, well, €10.50. What do they say? They say it's a foundation with a natural finish. Depending on the powder used, you can get the effect of a full matte, satin or illuminating effect. It's medium to full. Evens out skin tone, making it look smoother. Yeah, I kind of think it does, but it's difficult for me to say because the shade is too light. It always throws off my eye some. Never mind. They recommend applying with dampened sponge or one of their brushes. And building coverage, evens out skin texture, making it look smoother, slightly freezes, that's what it says, so it makes it extremely durable. So it sets on itself. And that is kind of what I feel, even though I have a hydrating primer underneath. But yeah, that was a little bit about the foundation. What I am going to do is the rest of my face. So I'm going to put on my other cream products to bronze it up a little bit. But first brows. Let's start with brows. Let's do those first. So I just have my Catrice Glam and Doll pencil here. I'm actually eyeing the one from NYX that they have, that very, very tiny felt tip pen, or very small felt tip pen. I'm very curious about that one, actually. I'm just putting on the highlighter from Essence. I've already done my powder products except for blush. And basically, I concentrated my bronzer on the points that I usually bronze and faded everything out on the rest of my face to kind of even everything out. And that works. I don't know about the blush, though. I kind of want to try this one, too, but I don't know what it does. I hope I can open. Oh, no, don't fall. So let's see what it does. It's so difficult today. It's a shimmery one, but I don't really know what kind of shade I want to make of it, you know? I almost feel like it is like my shade Fielding, maybe a more, I don't want to say neutral, but yeah, something like that. Which I think in summer I would use as a blush topper. It's pretty though, I just don't really know what it does, to be quite honest with you. But yeah, we will leave it on anyway. I just need to try that one out a little bit more. Let's, for funsies, pop the one from Catrice over it because it's a little bit of an orangey. Something along those lines. Okay. My makeup will be listed down in the description box in case you want to know what else I put on the face. Okay. Yes, I'm ready for the close-up, Mr. DeMille. We are ready for the pièce de résistance, the eyeshadow palette. Let's prime the eyes first with the Natasha Denona eye base. I think I have an idea. Okay. Let's see how many eyeshadows I can cram on my eye. Okay, I am going to start with this one, the lightest one. And it's going to go very kick-uppy in the pen, which I actually thought it would be. It's going to go in the inner eye part area. And I think this will actually... Yeah, it does show up on me. Very lightly, but it does. So that will live here today. Okay. And then I'm going to go to the next shade, which is then Morella, this one. Same brush. Also pretty kick-uppy. It's going to go right next to it. Okay, so I finally have a plan. So this one is going to go a little bit more in. The reason that I'm packing these shades on with a denser, a slightly denser brush is because they are so light. I'm just going to blend the edge a little. Just a hint. Okay, next brush is going to be slightly more open. It is going to be this shade, and then after that this shade will go in the outer corner and underneath my eye, and this shade there. That's a little bit of the plan, at least. So now I'm going to go to, I don't know, Susona. That's how I want to pronounce it. I don't know if it's correct, but yeah. Again, very, very much, very kick-up-y. I don't mind that, though. Did I already say that? I think I did, right? Ooh, I like this color. Ooh, this is nice and bright. So I'm not only placing it here, but I also want it in the crease. More in, so I'm just going to pack it on a little bit lower. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. And then that lighter shade that I used here, I'm going to blend out this shade with. It's a very, very pretty shade. I like this, and I'm tapping it on. So probably, do I create fallout? Probably, but it usually does not really matter with shades like this, for me at least. And it feels very, very silky when I go over it with a brush. Then I'm going to go back to the previous shade. I'm just going to blend the edge a little. And maybe I will even use the lighter shade to blend out that. Because I can be fancy today. Then with a different brush, a cleanish one, I'm going to go to that first shade again, tapping it off, and then that last shade is going to be blended out with this. I usually don't work like this, but it sometimes it's fun, you know. It's kind of, I don't know, bring it up a little bit more towards the brow bone. It's a very, very pretty blend. Very, very pretty blend. Let's go to the hot pink. I don't really know if I want it underneath my eye now. I'm going to go first to the orangey shade. Because to be quite honest with you, I don't really know if I want to use it underneath my eye now. So I'm just putting this one down as a guide right now. The trouble is, I kind of now want to do more looks with this palette as well. So yeah, there's that. I will probably, I don't know, maybe I will use it in the next members video. I have an idea for the pink. I do. But I'm going to go to the shimmers next. So first, one eye shimmer, primer. Other eye, no primer. So let's start then with the eye that I'm not going to use primer on, because then my brush isn't ruined. I'm going to go to, I don't know, gem? This one. It's not really weird, it's going to go in the outer corner. This is dry, so let's see, I'm just going to tap it on. Oh, that's nice. I'm going to use it dry on the other side as well. And I've brought it up a tiny bit. So what I'm going to do is the brush that I used for that orangey shade, I'm going to blend here a bit, because I kind of want to use that darker base shade. And I don't mind a shimmer in the outer corner. Hell, I don't even really mind it in the crease either. But yes, I'm going to grab that orangey shade and pack it on underneath my eye. And I'm probably going to create fallout. That shimmer shade, I'm tapping off. Yeah, okay, that's nice. So I can basically use a little bit of the base shade right now. Oh, that's cute. Okay, the other shimmer, where is the brush? I really, really want to use this shade. So I am going to. Let's put it on dry here. Oh yeah. Nice. I'm going to spray it next. I'm going to build it up basically. So I have loaded up my brush. Then I'm going to spray. Oh yeah, I love this so much. And then I'm going to go in the darker shade with the other side of the brush. And just fade it over a bit. Oh, that's cute. Oh. Other side, glitter primer. So I'm going to clean my brush. I'm going to put on a little bit of glitter primer on my brush. And I'm going to use it on the lid. Lately I have not been using a lot of glitter primer because it tends to crease on me. But it is also sometimes, some shadows crease when I put on a glitter primer. Now these are a little bit more dry. When they are a little bit more dry, a lot of the time they don't tend to crease on me. So let's see what happens. Okay, and then I'm going to go back into that shade Bacal, but I don't know, the pretty one. So this is the same thing as if you were to spray. It's the same kind of intensity that you get. I do have to say though, it usually picks up better on the brush. So if you're like, yeah, I want that least amount of fallout, but I usually don't use a glitter primer, but I still have one. What you can do is put a little bit of glitter primer on the back of your hand and just coat your brush a little bit with it and then pick up the eyeshadow. That is also a possibility. What do I like? I think that when I look at the two sides now, this side with the glitter primer is a little bit darker than that side. But that could be me. That's how I view it. Okay, now for the funky part. Let's get an eye pencil. So, pink pencil from Root Cosmetics. Can you guess what I'm going to do? Yes, I do want that shade underneath my eye, I think. So, I'm actually going to grab some glitter primer for my lower lash line. And a tiny brush, coating my brush. I'm on top of my, well, basically beneath my lashes, or I try to. I'm going to put down a glitter primer. And then I'm going to grab that shade that I loved so much that I have on my upper eyelid. And it's going to go on top. And I'm extremely curious what this shade is doing on my upper eyelid, because unfortunately, while I love with a passion an orange shimmer, a lot of the time they really crackle on me, especially in the inner eye part area. I'm actually very curious to see what this one is doing. It doesn't appear to though. So it's probably because of that shift. Okay. Now I am going to go with a tiny brush. Into the hot pink, and that's going to go in the inner corner. And I will probably pick either this shimmer or this shimmer to put on top dry, because I have actually never done this and I think it will be fun. Or at least I think I've never done this, I don't remember. Okay, I'm cleaning my brush. Then I'm going to go into the shimmer that I have here, so that I can use that to pull that pink in a little bit without, I don't know, basically making the blend nice, the transition. Yes, same thing underneath my eye. I want this one, which is Confitura. Dry and I tapped it off. I just want that sparkle. And this also has a little bit of a peachiness in it. Funky! Yes! Okay, let me finish off the eyes. I only have lippy left, right? Yeah, so let me finish off the eyes until I'm ready for the lippy. And then I will put on the lippy together with you, or at least I will put on a lippy and you will watch. Hello, I'm back. Yeah, obviously. Everything is largely on. The only thing left for me to do is lippy. And I have chosen the lip liner color Jasny Karamelek, because I think it will complement the lippy I'm going to wear. And that's going to be this one, the most orangey one of the two, yeah. And it's the shade called Biskoptowa. Am I sounding Polish? I don't know. Let me whack this on. almost, yeah, what am I doing? Almost too light for what I like, but that's okay. Oh, this is very nice. Mm. I almost want to say it tastes like peach. You know those peachy sweets? But it could be just me. Maybe there's something wrong between the ears. I do really like this color though. And I like the fact that it is a satiny. It goes on very, very nicely. It feels very comfortable on the lips. I like it. I think it's a very, very pretty color. So here is the final form. Oh yeah, and I also changed out my shirt underneath the sweater. But you will already have guessed that. I feel very, I don't know, ready for summer. I almost want to go eat ice cream. I think it's very, very pretty. It's very, very cute. Let's start with order of application, what I use. Let's start with the foundation. Just before I hit record again, I actually looked in my 5x magnifying mirror and I scrutinized the foundation, and it is surprisingly pretty. Yeah, I hate the term, especially for the price, but for a foundation that retails for, say, 10 euro, it looks pretty. It feels like skin. I did powder it, but I powdered it lightly. It did set on its own, and it does not feel powdery. It doesn't look powdery. It doesn't look cakey. It basically looks like my skin. Yes, the shade is way, way, way too light. I can bronze it up as I did, so then I can make it work. But yeah, let me just zoom you in. It's the wrong side. That's hello. Let me tone down the brightness a bit. Let's go there first. Yes, I know. And then hit that. Yes. So this is a bit better. It does look very, I think it looks very, very pretty. I wish that for the olive spectrum they had a darker one. Well, hell, I wish they had darker shades regardless, because these foundations go very, very, very pale. Now, I know that, let me put everything back the way I want it. I am pretty impressed with the foundation, not gonna lie. I wish it would come in more shades, and especially a little bit more towards the darker spectrum. But if you are one of my pale ghosties, go check out the foundation, because there is bound to be one that is suitable for you. For me, I think the lightest one that Fenty has is the 145 in the olive spectrum, which is maybe now a hair too light. So I do mix in a little bit of a darker shadow. But if that shade is too dark for you, this shade could be for you. This is the olive one. And I also have one that's lighter. It's the olive zero, which I'm not going to try because, yeah, I made it work by basically placing my bronzer where I normally bronze and then bronzing up the rest of my face a little bit as well. That is what I did. But yeah, I am very impressed so far by the foundation. I don't know how it will wear, and I hope I won't forget to basically tell you how it wore and also how this wore. Yeah, so that is that. But please also remember that Glam Shop Poland is an indie brand. I don't know how big they are though. I don't think they are that big, but I could be mistaken. And I know it's also pretty expensive to make a lot of foundation shades. So yeah, I think that's it. I think, at least. I just hope that they will expand their shade range into the deeper spectrum now that they have started, one of the few brands that have started with a very, very pale range. I hope that they will most brands are in the middle, you know, and they are one side of the spectrum, and I hope they will expand to the other side of the spectrum as well. Next is then the eyeshadow palette, right? Yeah. Can I just say wow? I know you have pestered me forever. Try Glam Shop Poland because their formula is so good. Yeah, it is. I am very, very happy that I got palettes though, because I'm very terrible at choosing. Truly, I'm very, very bad at them. And they have more palettes that I was eyeing, but I was like, yeah, I want to get especially the green, because that green was so yummy to look at. And then I was like, I want this one too, because it's just, don't know. It makes me happy as well. And I'm so, so very glad that I did. The shadows performed beautifully. They have quite a bit of kick up in the pan. ABH level kick up in the pan. Yeah, I don't mind it though, because for me, I rather have a shade that has kick up than a shade that I have to dig my brush in because it's pressed so hard. But that is how I love my eyeshadows. So yeah, I could make everything work even on top of the Natasha Denona eye base, which is a little bit more darker than even my own skin tone. But if I tap it out, it is okay. It showed up very, very well. It does not look chalky. Even the lightest shades doesn't have that grayness that sometimes very pale pastel shades can have. They can have a gray cast almost. This one doesn't seem to have it, for me at least. The shimmer shades, yeah. Basically, the only matte shade I haven't used is this one. But I also want to do a pink look with this. Yeah, it's just... I think this shade will stain though. How's my finger? Yeah, it still has a little bit of pink on my finger. So I think this will stain. Not that I mind it personally. But yeah, and the shimmer shades, they are so, so pretty. I cannot wait to dig into the green one. But I have to say that the shades that are in here. You know what I want to say? If you really want to order from Sigil, for instance, because she has gorgeous shades, but you can't afford it, or I don't know what you want, is it in stock? Go check out Glam Shop Poland to see if they have similar shades, because truly, they are that good. Truly. And I really want to get more of those palettes. So yeah. Okay, let's then next go to the lippy. Yeah, the lip liners. When I swatch the lip liners, they are... they swatch pretty well, and then when I put them on my lips, I'm like, I don't see them until I come on top of my own lip color, and then I can see them. So they are pretty light for me as well. It was a little bit difficult to guess on the website, not gonna lie. But yeah, this one is a very, very, you can see it against my skin, very, very cool toned. This reminds me of the shade Amber from Fenty, the contour stick. It is so cool toned that it is almost a little bit purpley on me. And that was what I was going for. So yeah. And then this one is also pretty cool toned, but a little bit darker. Maybe I could have used this one as well. And then this is the one that I used, which I really like color wise. And I did not have a color like this. I kind of wish that I could find, I probably can. So if you know, please help me. The shade that I used today, I would love to have in a deeper tone. A few shades deeper. Same with this one. I would love them all actually a few shades deeper. But yeah, I don't know if they are there. But yeah, then the lippy. Yeah, there. I think it's very pretty. I think it is a very nice formula as well. And it smells. It smells like sweets. So I cannot talk anymore. I can't wait to try this one. I haven't tried this one yet, I believe. But yeah, I think that was it. Oh yeah, I can kind of quickly go over the Essence blush. Yeah, I think it's pretty, but I still don't really know if it is a blush or... I don't really know. I think it's a wonky color, but it's pretty. I could not really tell... I don't know, what is this? Is this a neutral blush? I don't know, it's sparkly. I think it's cute. I like the formula of the Essence face products a lot. I think that the highlighter is very pretty as well. It is maybe a little bit more demure, is that the word? But it is what I like. A very glittery highlighter. I don't know, it's just not something that I usually grab. I think it's pretty, but it's not some... I tend to grab more along the lines of these. And then this one is maybe I want some that one that's even a little bit darker. And then maybe a hint less yellow. I had one from Essence. That was the shade that I'm looking for. But it was in a palette and I don't have that anymore. But yeah, I do really like the formula. And I think that was it. Oh, I forgot the falsies. They are from Primark in the style Paris. I don't know how long I can wear these for. But yeah, and the Primark closest to me is going to close as well. So yeah, I don't know if I am able to get any more Paris and London style, probably if I go to Amsterdam. which I do want to do, but I don't know when. So yeah, that was it for today's video. Let me know if you have any of the goodies. Let me know if you can help me with the pencils, please do so. Let me just go to the site to give a special thank you to my members that you will see scrolling on the screen right now. If you want to become a member, there is a link to join in the description box. Yes. And I will, of course, link Glam Shop Poland as well. And I will list the rest of the makeup that I have on my face for your convenience. Yes, thank you so much for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I am going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. Or at least, may you be able to bronze it up if you need to. Or just put on a scarf. It's all good. I'm going to... See you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.